Good morning, everyone. I'm Eric from the community team at Milestone, an open platform company. You want always to have a seamless integrated face recognition software running on Milestone X Protect? If yes, stay tuned till the end, and Matthias Grunwald of SAFR will guide you step by step on how the awesome solution works. Here we go, Matthias. Impress the audience.
Great, Eric. Thank you. Thank you very much. And thank you for the opportunity to present SAFR to the Milestone community. As Eric outlined before, my name is Matthias Grunwald, and I'm doing business development and sales for real networks for our latest product called SAFR. SAFR is our facial recognition platform, which features an over-the-edge Milestone X Protect integration. Today on the agenda is that I would like to give you a short introduction about the company behind SAFR, then have a short overview of the platform itself, and then head over to a live demonstration, also including the integration, featuring the integration of SAFR into Milestone X Protect, and then closing it up with a wrap-up and obviously, of course, open to answer questions from your side. Okay, let's hope you have a comfortable seat, lean back, and let's go on an exciting journey about SAFR, the world's top premier facial recognition platform. First of all, Real Networks as a company, we are actually, as a global company, I'm located in Salzburg, Austria, where is also the EMEA headquarter of Real Networks. And out of Salzburg, my colleague and myself, we're doing business development in the EMEA region. But as you can see, Real Networks is really acting on a global level. The global headquarters of Real Networks is located in Seattle, Washington. At the same time, here's also the product management of SAFR done. In Europe, we also have an office in Zagreb, where the developers of SAFR are sitting, but also an office in Lisbon, which is covering the Southern Europe area, focusing on this part of Europe. All in all, Real Networks has about 600 employees with offices all around the globe. Sao Paulo in Brazil, covering LATAM. A couple of offices also in the APEC area, with the main headquarters of APEC located in Tokyo, Japan. Real Networks is not a startup. We are around for about 25 years, and you probably know the name because of the Real player, a big media player. And this also shows a little bit our connection to the video business and video processing, as we actually realized the very first video stream 1995 over the internet. So Real Networks sees itself as an innovative driven company, which is an internet pioneer and the founder, the inventor of streaming technology. Speaking of today, Real Networks is doing is actively doing a couple of businesses in various areas, such as mobile entertainment, mobile messaging, casual gaming, but also, of course, solutions in the area of artificial intelligence / machine learning. And this is actually where also our latest product, SAFR, is being located. SAFR is a facial recognition platform which is based on machine learning. The name SAFR stands for Secure Accurate Facial Recognition, and we launched the product last year in April. The company itself is looking about, for the last two and a half years, we're actually looking into machine learning and computer vision. And about a year ago, we then reached a point where we said, okay, we have a technology and now we make a product out of it. And this is called SAFR. And SAFR, obviously, as a facial recognition platform, has one very strong focus. And this is the recognition of persons under real life world conditions in live video motion. But what exactly does it mean when I speak about real life conditions? And as you can see here, on the right hand, you see the visa faces. This is the perfect image, the perfect shot. You notice from the passport, people looking straight into a camera. There's a perfect lightning, no facial expressions. There's no occlusion and no makeup. But this is not how people act or move in the real world. It's like wild faces. So you have actually the imperfect image of a person. People are camera unaware and they are in motion and they're partially occluded, for example. life conditions. Talking about occlusion, like sunglasses, like hats, like a scarf, like a makeup, diffuse lightening conditions, the imperfect angle, or maybe also facial expression. This is really what SAFR is standing out. And the reason why we are so good in this area is because we have access to a very unique data set. An algorithm based on machine learning is always as good as the data set you can train it with. And let me take one step back here and explain why we have access to this great data set. A couple of years ago, Real Networks launched an application. It was called Real Times. And Real Times is still doing maybe from Apple Memories or Google Photos. You installed the app and it was scanning your mobile device for content, videos, and photos. And based on the metadata, such as timestamp and geolocation, it knows which content belongs together to one event. And then based on certain algorithms, it was actually sorting out the good from the bad ones and creating instantly an animated video deer show on your device, which you could then share with friends and family. In order to share it, you would have to upload it to our cloud, and then you could actually share it. And we launched that product on a direct-to-consumer proposition, and we had about, on a global level, and we had about 20 million subscribers from all ethnicities around the globe. And we got permission from our users to use their content. And we're talking here about not stock images, but actually the imperfect image. It's like camera roll images, images taken by like somebody like myself or you guys, which are not under perfect conditions. And those images were uploaded to cloud, and we had the permission to train our algorithm with this content. So there were more than 20 million unique faces from all ethnicities and more than 100 million images we could train our algorithm with. And this is where actually SAFR stands really out in the recognition of persons under real life world conditions. This has also been certified by various independent institutions. So we are submitting our algorithm on the one hand to the University of Massachusetts, which is specialized or quite famous for its labeled faces in the wild test. It's a face recognition test focusing on wild faces. And we reached, the theoretical highest possible score with 99.86%. At the same time, we have now several times submitted our algorithm to NIST, the National Institutes of Standards and Technologies. And by the latest report, which was released back in April 2019, this is actually publicly available and can be downloaded and reviewed on the NIST website. We achieved an incredible grade score, and also NIST gave us two attributes, which I will talk in a minute, which actually make us the number one facial recognition platform currently speaking of today. So, talking about differentiators, talking about USPs, why SAFR? Why stand SAFR out from other facial recognition technologies and from our competitors? As just mentioned, we have an incredible high accuracy with 99.8%. Proven by independent institutions. With this accuracy, we actually belong to the very best facial recognition algorithms in the world. But when it comes to the performance, we are really the number one out there for two reasons. On the one hand, NIST gave us the attribute of being the lightest algorithm in the world. Speaking of, when it comes to the weight of an algorithm, this is in connection with the hardware requirements. And which is very, very important also when it comes to the total cost of ownership. When you think about facial recognition, you maybe have in your mind huge server racks with lots of high-end gaming graphic cards, which obviously are very, very expensive. So our goal was to make an affordable but still cutting-edge facial recognition solution. And we managed to slim down our algorithm become the lightest algorithm in the world. Again, this was verified by NIST and can be seen in the latest report. We really work with hardware off the shelf. Secondly, when it comes to the performance, we are also the fastest algorithm in the world, and this was also verified by NIST. We can do an end-to-end recognition below 100 milliseconds. And obviously, if you want to recognize persons in real-life world conditions, you want to be fast because people are not waiting in front of the camera, they are moving by. So you want to be really fast when you do the recognition. And therefore, I'm proud to say that we are the fastest algorithm when it comes to facial recognition. Last but not least, there's the third big area in regards to differentiators, or it's about flexibility. SAFR runs on every major operating system, talking about macOS, Windows, Linux, but also the mobile versions such as iOS or Android. SAFR can be deployed in the cloud, but it can be also deployed offline locally. And this is, I think, also something very, very important and a big USP, especially when it comes to security, because often those systems are not connected to the public internet, or maybe are completely offline, even not to an intranet connected. And in order to meet this requirement, and to use facial recognition with a complete offline security system, we said, okay, SAFR must run completely offline, and we have achieved it. So there is no computing power from the cloud actually needed. Obviously, of course, it can be hosted in the cloud, either in the cloud of real networks or in the partner in the private cloud of the customer. In case you want to have like a centralized database, you have a couple of sites where you want to use SAFR, but you want to use one centralized database, then in this case, of course, a cloud model could be applied. And last but not least, when it comes to flexibility, it's about cameras. Maybe you think about other providers require very special, sometimes very expensive cameras to work with facial recognition. SAFR is camera agnostic. Speaking of, it works with every IP camera out there. That's it. No need to have a new set of cameras. If you have an existing CCTV infrastructure, you can apply SAFR easily and without any need of enhancement in regards to the cameras. Okay, now let's move on. And I'm very excited to tell you now about the partnership between SAFR and Milestone. Back this year at the ISC West in Las Vegas, Real Networks announced a new initiative in regards to SAFR, and it was called SAFR for Security. And this initiative focuses on the integration of SAFR into premium VMS. And obviously, our first partner was, of course, Milestone. The Milestone community is an exciting one. It's a global one, and we are very happy and proud to say that we have successfully integrated our technology into the Milestone Expert App, into the premium VMS, speaking of today. And I will show you in a minute what kind of features we are actually providing with this integration. Before I go a little bit deeper here, let me quickly switch my browser into my browser and show you quickly our presence on the Milestone Marketplace. As you can see here, there's a full-featured page which gives a great overview about SAFR itself. As you can see, we are Milestone verified. It works with up to 1,000 plus cameras. And it also shows you a little bit more high level information, which we will walk you through in a minute. How it actually works and how you can actually install it. So you find also a SAFR for Milestone installation guide on our website. On the marketplace, you find a specification sheet, and you also find some information in regards to SAFR and GDPR. As you can see here, there's like this flyer about SAFR and our integration with Milestone. It shows some features. It gives us a little bit technical information about system requirements and basic information. I will walk you through that in a minute. And also you find, because it's very important when it comes to data privacy, obviously in combination with facial recognition, there are some advices in regards to the GDPR, which of course must be treated with high respect. Switching back now to the presentation. I'm excited now to show you how we are actually integrated into the Milestone Expert Head. We have a couple of key features, starting with live video overlays. So within the management smart client, you will actually have visual indication of, based on the person type and the person status, which gives you the possibility to do a real-time identification. I will show you that in a minute. Based on the identification, most important is you want to get alerted. You want to trigger events based on the recognition of persons. Therefore, we have integrated alarms and notifications, which can provide an instant notification of security events based on the definition of a person type. I will explain that a little bit later, more in detail. We have automatic bookmarks. So whenever somebody is being recognized, or actually when an event is being triggered, an automatic recording, an automatic bookmark is being created with searchable metadata. So you can actually scan your recorded video by names of persons, by person types, in order to find the desired piece of video footage. Last but not least is all results in live analytics, because SAFR does not only recognize a person, it also provides demographic information for this person, speaking of the gender and the age, but also the sentiment. But especially the age and the gender are very valuable information when you think about the vertical of retail and you want to provide very valuable marketing information. Then this is really actionable data for reporting, which is being provided by SAFR through the Milestone Expert Head. So this was a quick overview about the key features. And I think the very best is not just to talk about it, but to actually show what is being possible and how this is being set up. By this, I'm going to switch now to, first of all, to the management client. By the way, you can see me. Hi guys, it's a pleasure to talk to you today. So what you can see here is actually that we have set up a Mobotics camera, a Mobotics M16. This has been configured in the management client. And now I'm going to switch over to the SAFR client, which can be seen here. As you can see, we have here selected, configured the same camera also in the SAFR client. And within the preference menu, you see that there's a dedicated milestone tab. And within this milestone tab, you actually need a couple of credentials from the management client in order to establish a connection between the SAFR client and the management client of Exprotect. Once this is being set up and the camera stream is being shared, it is actually possible to get some information regarding the active overlay connections. So actually we need this IP address here, which is automatically being provided once SAFR is talking to the management client. And with this IP address, we can actually configure the MIP driver/SDK. This is responsible for transferring the metadata from the SAFR client to the Exprotect smart client. Once this has been properly configured, we actually just need to select the camera and assign the MIP driver to this camera in order to ensure that the metadata is correctly being submitted, being transferred from SAFR to the Exprotect client. Once this is being set up, that's it basically already. We can now switch over to the smart client, which I'm doing now. And as you can see here, here's the Mobotics camera we have just configured before or seen before. And I'm now adding a new window. And you see that there's the active overlay also with the respective tracking within the smart client of X-Protect. So you see my name, you see that there's a green circle which indicates that I'm a non-threat. I'm basically a named person, and it also recognizes my gender and it does my age. Obviously, it looks to me, from quite an angle. I'm 38, so I think we're pretty good based on how the camera is actually watching me. If I look a little bit more direct into the camera, it actually, nails it down to 38, which is, I think, a great result. So as you can see, the facial recognition also works quite from an angle. I'm not really looking straight into the camera. And if I would now, for example, move that away, just waiting for a second until it loses me, it should happen in a minute. And I'm going here again. And as you can see, the recognition is really instantly. And this is actually now going over the cloud. And the speed is really very, very fast. If you would do that on a complete local installation, then it would be even a tick faster. But I think this is already a very, very positive result. I have now prepared also something which a little bit of a lice test with a little bit of occlusion. So what I will do now is actually put on a cap and wait a second until, okay. And even with the cap, I'm immediately recognized here. And in order to make it even harder, I will now put on sunglasses. The cap and sunglasses. And let's see, even with cap and sunglasses, it manages to recognize me immediately and tracks my face. So this is the live overlays we are going to feature with SAFR and the X-Protect integration. Next feature would be the alarms. Switch over to the alarm manager, minimize the live overlay image here. And as you can see, for all the recognitions which were being made, an event is being created, SAFR named person detected with a timestamp and actually the camera. I will now switch back to the management client. You can see here in alarm definitions that I have defined this alarm. SAFR named person analytics event. And it's about detecting somebody who is being treated as a non-threat, as a named person. We are now going to do, I'm switching back, we're now changing my person status. Just need to close the preferences first. The people management is actually done within the SAFR client. So all people who are being enrolled are shown in the SAFR client. For example, that's me here. Just needs a little of loading time until the picture comes up. The ID class you see is a non-concern. However, I will change that now to a threat. Update. And as you can see, the circle indicates that I'm not a named person, a non-concern people anymore, but a threat with a red circle around my face. And now we're going back to the management client and adding actually a new alarm. So we're going here to SAFR threat. The trigger event is an analytics event. And because of the integration now in the drop-down menu, you will find all the various SAFR events. So in this case, we make it threat detected, assign this one, select the respective camera. Click away to save this. Okay. And now we're actually going back to the smart client. And I'm going to create a new event. As you can see here also in the live overlay, we have the, you can see that the overlay also in the smart client has now been changed. It's now red, indicating that there is a threat person being detected. And if we go back to the alarm manager, minimize this image, you can see here immediately that a new event has been created with a threat detection. The beauty of this is that you can actually trigger various events based on the person's status. So if you have a threat detection, you can actually immediately close doors and alarm security staff. But if you have like an unknown or stranger person, you can maybe open up a door. If there's like a named person who is entitled to access the room, then you can unlock a door, for example. So this is the events and the alarms which can be used. And now, last but not least, as mentioned before, we have also the automatic bookmark. So if I go here to playback, you can actually see that with all the events, bookmarks have been created, like this one. In this case, a SAFR threat person detected with my name, and there's the recording while I'm speaking, actually, and presenting to you. So this, in a nutshell, features or shows the features of SAFR within the Milestone X-Protect client. Switching now back to the presentation again. Oops, closing this window. Okay. Talking about, now as we've seen all the features, let me quickly talk about the technical architecture. So basically, we have three components. We have Milestone, which consists of the X-Protect server and the smart client. We have SAFR with the SAFR application, and we have a SAFR server. So quite similar here. For the setup I've just shown you on my PC, on my gaming laptop, which I'm using right now, we have those components, the X-Protect server and the smart client being installed on this machine, but also the SAFR application is running on this machine. Only the SAFR server sits now in the cloud. It's connected to the cloud. And on the server is actually where the actual algorithm sits, the model sits. And here we actually is then where the matching is happening. Here, as you can see, the IP cameras submitting the video stream to the X-Protect, and X-Protect talks to the SAFR application. On the application, we're actually doing the video processing and creation of biometric signatures, which is then being transferred to the server where the actual matching is happening. Based on this, we can then trigger events and analytics. That's, in a nutshell, a quick overview of the technical architecture. In theory, all components could sit on the same machine, but depending on the load, speaking of how many cameras you're going to connect and how many concurrent faces you want to monitor, it's maybe advisable to split it up and put it on different machines. Again, the whole SAFR part can be on-prem and does not need to be connected to the internet. So what kind of system requirements are actually needed? And I always say, okay, they're always a little bit overpowered, but there's still some buffer in there. But when you have like 8 cameras with 4K resolution or 1080p, but in this, let's stick to the 8 4K cameras, with 5 visible faces and a 4K resolution running per 15 frames per second, you would need an Intel Core i9, 16 gigabyte RAM, and like a MIDI core gaming graphic card. So the NVIDIA GeForce, I think, is around 500 euros. And you could monitor 40 faces, concurrent faces at the same time on a 4K, on 8 4K cameras. This would be for the cloud. So this would be the configuration for the edgeware, which sits close to the camera and does the video processing. If you want to have a complete on-prem installation, you would need 2 components. You have the platform, as shown before, and you would have the edgeware desktop application. So for the platform, you would need also a little bit of a stronger CPU, 32 gig of RAM, and then for the desktop, obviously you need a not so strong processor and the same graphic card as shown before. Again, this is for the same, and this is the recommended and probably a little bit overpowered, I would even say, but it's always good to have a little bit of a buffer. Again, when you want to have 8 4K cameras and 40 concurrent faces you want to monitor. Obviously, what can be done with SAFR? What's about the use cases and the verticals? This is probably a very exciting area as well. And honestly speaking, the sky has no limits. The possibilities are kind of endless. So from the use cases, we see a very strong focus in the areas of security and monitoring, of access control, tracking and analytics, VIP convenience and loyalty, or any other custom solutions which can be built using our REST API or our SDK, which is also available within the SAFR portal. And those use cases can be applied to the same use cases where I think the Milestone community is also very, very much focusing on, to, such as healthcare, smart city, transportation, or retail, even education. Think about the campus where you want to do security monitoring. This is an initiative we have actually launched in America. It's called the K-12 School Initiative. K-12 is kind of a middle school, and you know that in America, security in schools is a very, very big and important topic. The World Network actually decided to give away a free basic version of SAFR to schools in the States in order to increase the security level. It's being used for security monitoring, but also for access control. An area which I really like is about healthcare. Healthcare, and because there are so many positive use cases you can apply in this certain area. For example, especially in the Benelux, we have very great engagement in the healthcare sector, because I think also those territories are very innovative when it comes to healthcare. So think about people who are physically not anymore able to open doors. You can create a barrier-free entry by using facial recognition. Or you maybe have people who have dementia, so you have a dementia home, and there is a risk that people are actually getting lost. And unfortunately, in this very important sector, healthcare, there's a general understaffed situation. So in order to minimize the risk, or actually to prevent of people getting out of the dementia home, you can use facial recognition in combination with an EMS, a VMS, to control the doors, the entries and exits, and prevent of somebody getting actually out and getting lost or maybe hurt himself. And when you think about retail, as shown before, you can not only provide demographic analytics to a mall owner who wants to know which is actually my audience. And besides people counting, you can do demographic analytics such as gender and age. But actually, you could also track people by coming in and check their ways in a mall and see what actually great kind of a heat map and see where are the heat points within your mall. Or when you think about live events and security monitoring, I'm a big sports fan, think about a football stadium, and obviously this should be a family-friendly atmosphere. You don't want to have antisocial behavior within a great football game, because you want to enjoy it with your children, with your family. So SAFR in combination with the X-Protect can help the security staff to filter out hooligans before they actually are going into the stadium, as one case, for example. But the other one would also identify antisocial behavior within the stadium in a certain sector. Or if you want to apply it to the VIP convenience or loyalty use case, then you could also provide, again, barrier-free access to VIP lounges or have an optimized check-in process for loyal customers and visitors. Again, I could talk, I think, probably another hour about use cases and the verticals, but that the possibilities are really, really endless. Maybe one more example, which we are actually currently working on, is in Spain. There's a big supermarket chain, and they have about more than 1,000 shops, and the security staff just can't manage to monitor everything, and there's a big problem with gangs, with organized criminals who are really shoplifting and creating an aggressive atmosphere within the shops. But again, with the extra tech and with SAFR, you can immediately be notified if somebody on a watch list is entering one of the more than 1,000 shops and alert the security staff and trigger required actions. Okay. Yes, I think we're coming close to the end, so I would like to do a short wrap-up of SAFR and what we have heard in the last 20-25 minutes. Why SAFR again? The USPs. SAFR is not only the fastest algorithm, it's also the lightest algorithm, facial algorithm right there, speaking of today, out there in the world. It works with every IP camera, it runs on every major operating system, it can be deployed in cloud or on-premise, and it's fully integrated with the Milestone X-Protect. Speaking of, we have... Sorry for that, there was an issue with the presentation right now. Please let me quickly change that. Just a second, sorry for that. Okay, just switching. So we've seen the live video overlays, we have seen the alarms and notifications, and we've also seen the automatic bookmarks. Those are the key features which are integrated in the X-Protect. And last but not least, obviously a very important question to answer is about SAFR pricing. Let me give you a short overview about the commercial model. So what you see here are MSRP. And we basically feature two models. So we have on the one hand a subscription model, which is hosted on the customer side, and a subscription model, which is hosted by SAFR in the Real Networks Cloud. Let's start with the first model, which is hosted at the customer side. Here we actually have a standard subscription, which is for 12 months. And we also have another model, which is then for 36 months, for 3 years. As you can see, it's per camera. So we're not doing a commercial model based on the amount of persons in the database, which honestly speaking is kind of unlimited. So we have managed to have successfully tested the database with more than 1 million faces in the database. And actually now we're looking into it to increase that to 2 million. Again, this is not, it's not related to the commercial model. The amount of faces being enrolled in the database is unlimited. The same applies to the amount of recognition events. This is also unlimited. So it's really to make it as simple as possible. You have one camera and you need one license. And you would pay for the, in the lowest tier, MSRP is €729 for one SAFR license, which can be applied to one camera. Of course, there's a discount if you go now for the 36-month subscription. In this case, you would pay for one license, for one camera, €1,521. As you can see, this is a tiered model. So the more volume, the cheaper it actually gets. Then there's, last but not least, there's also the standard subscription hosted by SAFR. So in this case, it's hosted in our cloud. Obviously, it's slightly more expensive because we have to pay the data center costs for the cloud computing, actually. So in this case, we would speak about €1,151 for one license for one camera, This is also for 1 year. Everything is built in advance. And of course, all those models feature a free trial period in order to get familiar with the system and in order to convince yourself if this is the right solution or not. Okay, that's it now from my side. I want to thank you very much again for your time and the audience. If there are any questions, I'm more than happy to answer them right now. Of course, they can also be addressed afterwards per email. And I think I also agreed with Eric that we will send out another thank you email, which also will include some informational stuff like the slides I've shown you, but also the Expotech Milestone flyer we have created. Thank you very much.